In this video series, I'm going to explain to you how you can install e-commerce tracking onto your purchase pages so your e-commerce tracking in Google Analytics gets filled and you can send data on to the Facebook Pixel or Google Ads. All or more coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with another video for you. Today we want to talk about e-commerce tracking, a topic that I have avoided over the years to actually put on the channel because it's so much more complex than what you think about, as there are many different platforms out there like Shopify or Magento, and for every platform it's differently installed. So I always tend to stay away from it as it bred a lot of questions. I have a whole video series inside of our membership site, Measure Masters, but today I want to take a little attempt at solving this issue for you, the e-commerce tracking, as we're going to install, and I'm going to show you how to install, enhanced e-commerce transaction tracking onto your purchase pages. This is just a tiny bit of the enhanced e-commerce tracking feature set of Google Analytics, but I wanted to show it so you know how this process would go along, because we need to install an extensive data layer, and then we can transfer that information onto Google Analytics and also to our Facebook Pixel or our Google Ads conversion tracking. Now, as I mentioned at the beginning, this is more complex than it seems, and therefore I wanted to take my time and I've split this up into three parts. In this first part, we're going to cover what we're actually going to install and what we need to prepare in order for us to go the next step, which is setting up the data layer, which we're going to do in this second video. And then in the third video, we are actually going to set up our tags so we can take that sweet information that we have now in the data layer and forward it on to our tools, to Google Analytics, Facebook Pixel, and Google Ads conversion tracking. Now, as I said, we got lots to cover. Let's dive in. All right, welcome back to our demo shop. On this demo shop, we want to install Google Analytics e-commerce tracking today. So just to demonstrate what this would look like, I'm going to go through a quick order here. And once I get to the thank you page, we can see that we have several tags firing here. At the heart of all of this is our Google Analytics event, enhanced e-commerce, that sends our data over to Google Analytics. This is done in form of an event. So in Google Analytics, under the real-time reporting, we should be able to see our event information that just came in. Here we go. Our transaction information. And this sends with it data from our data layer that we have implemented. So what products were bought, the transaction ID, and so on. We also have an extension available for our Chrome browser. So if you go into the developer tools, we should be able to see what data got sent over. The extension is called the GTM GA debugger, which you can install onto your browser. I'm going to reload this here. And here we have a tab called Enhanced E-commerce that we can click, and this is where it was sent to and all the information that was sent over with our order. Later on, we should be able to see this inside of Google Analytics under our conversion reports here under e-commerce, and then we should have our sales performance, for example, filled with the information that we have retrieved from our data layer. Additionally, as you might have seen, I also fire a Facebook purchase event and a conversion purchase event to Google Ads, but that's something we're going to set up in the end. So how will this implementation go down? At the heart of all of this is a special kind of data layer. This is an enhanced e-commerce tracking data layer that we need to implement onto our page. This is not something that we presumably be able to do ourselves unless we use a plugin or it's already pre-installed. But I'm going to show you a way to write specification for your developer to get this implemented correctly. Once this is there, we'll be able to configure our tags. We're going to go through this step by step, but also going to give you a container download in the description below so you can install this easily to your Google Tag Manager container. Last but not least, we should be able to see our data in Google Analytics, Facebook, and Google Ads, and have our tracking correctly set up. Now, what do you need in order for this implementation to work? First of all, you would need to have Google Tag Manager installed, which we obviously have here already.
If you're not sure if Google Tag Manager is installed correctly, go into your Google Tag Manager account and click on the preview button to see if on your page then your preview mode pops up. This is an indication that Google Tag Manager is correctly installed. Then on the Google Analytics side, we also need to prepare something. In the admin section, you will need to go under the view that you send the data to, under the e-commerce settings here, and enable e-commerce and also enable enhanced e-commerce reporting. Save this and we have our Google Analytics prepared to receive that data. Last but not least, you probably want to figure out a way that you can do test conversions easily on the shop that you're working on, either offline on your local machine, or if this is a live site, you might want to get a coupon code set up or a test credit card, because we will be working with this order received page, which we obviously only can get to once we go through the whole checkout flow. So this will not be a one-time thing. So best is to get something set up that you can do this more often in order to see if your data is coming through correctly. Now with this in place, let's get started setting up our data layer in the next lesson.
All right, this is it with the first part of this three-part video series. If you haven't yet, then maybe subscribe if the video is not yet out, but maybe you can already find it here. So follow along in the next video, and I'll see you over there.